Dear men and boys, I'm talking to you now. Think about your grandmothers, mothers, wives, sisters, daughters. Think about them not having same possibilities or human rights to get education, work, or the same salaries as the men and the boys next to them. Think about how simple it is, in fact, to respect the rights of them all if we, men and boys, are ready to say no more inequality.
Privilege is invisible to those who have it. It is a luxury, I will say, to the white people sitting in this room not to have to think about race every split second of our lives.
And I want them to live in a world where my son and my daughters will have the same opportunities.
That the boxes that we've developed and assigned over time on the basis of a very narrow idea of gender are problematic in so many ways. If you look after children, you're not a real man. If you don't lead, you're not a real man. If you stay at home and look after an aging parent, your masculinity is the price you pay. This is too small a box. It's an unconscionable confinement of human talent and compassion.
A more subconscious level, that in some situations, when you see a man and a woman, unconsciously you think the man is better suited for this. Why, I don't know, but it's subconscious. That kind of discrimination is really hard to detect.
We were trying to change the world, but we weren't trying to change gender roles. It didn't occur to me. Mm-hmm. Might be that's the blindness of privilege, because you're looking at these things from a particular angle. It didn't occur to me. I don't think
so. Now our takeaway is, since this is unconscious, we're kind of off the hook, right? It's not our fault. But now that you know, what can we then do knowing that this is there?
And we know all need to stand up against stereotypes that keep girls and women behind and aback in their careers, in their lives, in their aspirations. And that has to be done continuously.
And that takes a lot of self-policing, looking inside and thinking, making a deliberate effort to be impartial.
The more we have conversations like this, the higher likelihood we're going to achieve that world.
And it's time that we broke out of those boxes once and for all.